Welcome back again to Matt Travis, and this, once again, is the Stone Whisperer with episode 2 of our Matt Travis Construct Quarter adventure, shall we say. So, today we will be facing the flesh giant Grobulus. So you can see a little picture of him up here with a horrible looking syringe there, and he's got the ability Poison Cloud. Deals one damage to all minions. If any of them die, it'll summon a slime. So, let's go ahead and choose him. So now we have to think about what we will use. So because of the damage done to minions, either a priest which can heal, a ramp druid which can get big minions out, or a shaman that has maybe an ability that can be used. Tell you what, let me just check. So that's a 2-cost spell. So, hero power. I'm going to go for a ramp druid. Get some big minions out, hopefully, and basically stick it to them. So here we are, riding the spiders, and here we have Grobulus versus my druid, Malfurion Stormrage. So let's have a look at the cards. We have a Harvest Golem, a Gnomish Inventor, and a Chillwind Yeti. Now, these type of druid decks are all based on getting basically 4 mana and above creatures out quickly. However, to do that, we need to have certain spells available to us. Innervate and I forgot what we're on. If you see it, I'll tell you. So we need to mulligan, that's what it's called, you know, it's this part of the game, these out, and try and hope that we get an innervate or wild growth, that's the word. So let's see. It's probably not as effective. I've got a couple of little spooky spiders. Now these have death rattle. Summon 2/1/1 spiders. Probably not the best for this game. So let's have a think about this now. So I'll, instead of attacking, because I can attack and kill, I can also put out a creeper, but if he attacks, I have to kill the creeper, and he could use his poison cloud, and that would be, well, end of. Now, I have Wrath, and the important bit is the last bit of that sentence. 1 damage and draw a card. Now, I want to try and get to the cards I need very, very quickly. And I can remove a minion and draw a card here. So, as you can see, deal 3 damage to minion, or deal 1 damage to minion and draw a card. I'll pick that. He has a death rattle ability, so I will take a little bit of damage. That's okay though, it's expected. So, what does he play now? Okay, that's quite a tough card. And I'm 1 turn away from removing it. So our best option at the moment is put out a spider. That way. Now he. Ah, perfect. So I did play that one well. yes or no. What I can do is, I just thought. So, this poison cloud ability deals 1 damage to all minions. In this case, it will also deal 1 damage to this egg. And when I break it, or when it gets broken, then it summons a 4/4 Nerubian. Not ideal, to say the least. However, we can deal it for now. So I'll go ahead and attack, and now wait my time out. Okay, so it's looking a little bit tougher than I thought here. I need to put out a minion fairly quickly. So let's see how we. Oh, this isn't good. Actually, it's fine. I have this card, which lets me destroy him immediately. So I'll play the Big Game Hunter, because it kills a minion, attack of 7 or more, sorry, and we can click there, so that's him gone, fantastic. Now, I need to heal up fairly quickly. Again. So we're still a little bit stuck. Let's see, what can we do? Regardless of what I'm doing, probably going to be a good idea to at least get a little bit off. Now, actually, I'll summon this. It gives me a bit of protection. I'll attack. Fortunately, I do take a bit of damage. I can trade him off. That's not ideal again. So, not going to plan. Let's sort of think about this though. So, we are. Little bit in a pickle. Let's get some minions out and attack that. That gives us another ability. And Rohi. So that's a wild growth card I was talking about earlier, however. It is a little bit too late. Now, we have what's known as a combo setup. So it's a combination of two cards. Now this is Force of Nature, summons 3/2/2 Ents with charge that die at the end of a turn. And Savage Roar, which gives your characters +2 attack this turn. Now, the force of nature, so that would be, just on its own, would be 6 damage. So I'll take him down to 19. We then have 17 damage. So let's count up actually, it's always easier. So that's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 damage. Now it would be 13 damage of that. So if we add plus 2, so that's 19, 21, 23, and 25. I also get plus 2 as well. So it looks like we managed to escape this one just in the nick of time. So I'll summon the Ents. As you can see here, everybody's ready to attack. And then I'll give them a little bit of a boost. And I'll let them attack and finish off poor Trobulus. Just in the nick of time though, managed to get that one done. So, that's great. A victory for us, as Kel'Thasad says down there. Back to a drawing board for him. And that should unlock another set of cards. The Mad Scientist. It's just got the Death Rattle. Put a secret from your deck into the battlefield. So, if you run decks that have secrets, that's great. I tend not to run them as it can be a little bit too unpredictable for my liking. So, we'll click off there, and as you can see, we've won. We're a little bit closer to getting level 32 in the Druid. And in the meantime though, thanks very much again. We've got another 2 bosses to go. And hopefully won't be quite as nerve-wracking as the last time. So thanks very much everybody for watching. It's greatly appreciated. Let everybody know, share, etc. Do your thing. Thanks very much. Have a great day now. Bye bye.